It's our first time going to a conference together and all together too.
Oh yeah.
The great thing about this one is that there's childcare available. Guys, I'm not wearing foundation.
What is that on here?
Oh, nothing.
I'm just kidding.
It's just blush. Did you miss touching my face? I didn't let you touch my face for like 6 years. Seven years. Yeah. He never got to touch my face for seven years.
Now I'm like, I don't even know how to touch your face anymore.
I'm gonna get acne.
He said, we went door to door from Longueuil to Chambly, about 150,000 people.
Deux fois.
Twice.
Une personne a accepté le Seigneur.
Only one person came to Jesus.
C'est ça, annoncer l'évangile. C'est ça, annoncer l'évangile.
That's what it is to preach the gospel.
Not only because of the history that we need to understand behind them, but because they deal with a category which has almost completely disappeared among Westerners.
Okay, so this is your picture. And in 2 to 3 weeks, you'll get an information package mailed to you in that address. And yes. So that will tell you more about visiting, writing letters, sending.
I'll just check it out. Mm.
It looks so good, oh my gosh.
Something stuck in.
This is so glamorous.
I think I scratched my iris or something.
Your cornea?
My cornea.
You can't scratch your iris.
Okay.
Your iris is a hole. I just want to talk a bit because. Oh my gosh, God is so good. That's all. That's the summary. Because after burning out from working, I started like turning to finding community and finding engagement and fulfillment in Maple Story World. And I kept digging myself, like treating yourself is good and having rest time is good. Having social time is good. But when you are taking that and making it your everything, and it just kept getting bigger and bigger in my life. And I think at the point that Hammy passed away, I realized, I was like, oh my gosh, what am I doing and how am I living? And like, this is just getting deeper and deeper. I'm just eating myself into this cake that I considered a treat, but it's literally suffocating me. There's cake in my nostrils, there's cake in my ear holes, there's cake in my eyeballs, and I'm just eating this cake into this ground, and I'm like 3 feet deep into this cake. I had to stop and think, like, oh my gosh, like, I wish I was there for Hemi to notice that she was growing weaker and that it was time for her to pass. Like, I wish I was there to comfort her during her passing. And I realized, like, oh my gosh, like, this is not okay. Like, this is Hammy, but it's the kids. Like, this is, I can't live like this. And I made like a small little whisper, like, God help me through this addiction. Like, take me, like, save me somehow. And he just totally flipped my world. He just made it so that, like, right now I can't do anything except just cling to him, because I'm facing a lot of persecution and false claims. Yeah, it's been a lot, but I'm so surprised that I'm not shaking. Like, normally from one little comment saying, oh, this is all a lie, like, you're lying in this story time, like, I would be really affected by that. Right now, I'm being, like, slashed left, right, and center, but, like, I feel unscratched. You know what I mean? Like, I'm having these, like, darts thrown at me, but it's not even touching me. And I feel like it's only because of what God is doing to my heart. And the timing cannot be perfect enough, where we're at this conference and we're being like poured with messages and encouragements and truths and conviction and poured with discernment and wisdom. And at the same time, right when I let God like retouch my heart and address my sin of just idolizing this game and all the interactions that come with this game and all the things that I can escape from with this game, like right the moment that I let him, he just takes that and swoops me and makes it so that I can only rely on him. I don't know how many of you have like a faith experience or a faith life, I guess. I don't know, so far this has been my experience the last like 2 days. And I keep crying because I'm just in awe of God's power and his love. He's just so wild. I don't know how to explain this without sounding too preachy, because this is the Gospel Coalition. This is my faith in Jesus Christ. Of course it's gonna sound preachy, but like in my selfishness, in my blindness, like I don't want to see anything. I don't want to think about my responsibilities. I don't want to think about the hurt that I'm causing my family. I don't want to think about the hurt that I'm causing my work. But I just want to indulge and like bury myself in this pleasure that I think is valuable. And above everything, like disobeying what God would want for my life in a healthy life. He just disregards all of that selfishness and still comes and redeems and saves my terribleness in his way. Dad, I'm having a hard time. I don't know how to explain this. Maybe I should have been filming it while I was explaining it to you.
Explaining what?
This whole thing.
God has aligned us and using this to build your heart.
It's the last day of the conference. It's only a half day. We were thinking maybe we can't go because my body has been super compromised the last few days. My legs have been swollen from my thighs down, and my foot injury is like returning. Also, my head has been hurting from like my eyeballs. I feel like my brain's gonna fall out of my eyes. But I was like, you know what? I need truth in my heart, and we should be there. It's been blessing me so much. And it's different when you listen to a podcast and when you're there being anointed with wisdom from a speaker who's right in front of you. I just hope that my body will continue to be sustained. Well, that escalated quickly. Like in this vlog, it's literally like, oh, we're gonna go to the conference, yay! Some road shots, some like speaker shots, and then there's me crying. It's like suddenly escalated. Love you.
Much of the pain of crucifixion was muscle spasm. You hung on the cross and pulled with your arms and pushed with your legs to open up your chest cavity so that you could breathe.